rather what are evil spirits?
Kati mioyo ya Emma sikiri kama.
I know we talked again here about Satan.
Mina sima hangata, usema ukwanga litawala Satan, kapaina Satan kasiri.
Who at one time was called Lucifer.
Mioyo kana kwa yeye Mungu, yana vizo hizo la Lucifer.
Of course that is still his name.
Ni kama ni kilivizo leo alifika shimbulwa, isali la hai.
But before he was fallen.
So what are
demons? I want you to have a clear definition of what demons really are. Demons
matimona
are disembodied wicked beings. They are disembodied. Or let me say, they are wicked or evil spiritual beings. Yes, spiritual beings that are constantly at war against the kingdom of light. So when I say they are disembodied, it means that they are without bodies. They do not have flesh and blood. Even though their influence can be felt in the physical world, what they can do can be touched. What
you
need to understand about demons is that they don't have bodies. Everything that they are a spirit. Spirits don't have bodies. In four classes that I mentioned one other
time,
God is a spirit. According to John chapter 4, and verses 23, somewhere
that
23-24. God is a spirit.
Then
angels, where we have the upright and the fallen angels are also spirits. Angels are also spirits. According to the book of Hebrews, chapter 1 and verse 10, that says, are angels not ministering spirits? Are angels not ministering spirits? Sent forth by God to those that are saved. So angels are their spirits also. Satan and his demons, they are also spirits. And man also is a spirit. So we are saying demons don't have bodies. They are wicked spiritual beings. They are beings. They are spiritual beings, wicked in their nature, which are disembodied. And I said they are constantly at war against the kingdom of light. They have never been on the side of God. They can never just be on the side of God. They have never been on the side of truth. They have always been on the side of lying. So anything that is of light is an enemy to the evil spirits or the demons. So you need to understand this, that they are spiritual wicked beings. They are wicked spiritual beings. I want to get a change. In the unseen world.
So don't forget this one. That demons are disembodied, wicked, evil spiritual beings that are constantly at war against the kingdom of God. In the book of Ephesians chapter 6 and verses 4, the Bible makes it very clear about the evil spirits. It says that our warfare is not against human beings, but it is against spiritual wicked forces. Powers of this dark world, against authorities, and also against the rulers and the wicked forces in the world. So the Bible clearly indicates to us that our war is constantly not against flesh and blood, but against spiritual forces. And this is what actually we are talking about here. Here is another thing about the evil spirits. Let's look at Luke chapter 24, verse
39.
Since demons are spirits, we have said they don't have flesh. They don't have bones. There is no blood in them. Meaning they are intangible. According to Jesus. In Luke chapter 24 and verse
9.
Can somebody read it quickly if you found it, because I don't have time. Luke chapter 24 verse 9. What does the Bible say? Louder.
But
Bible
reads, "Behold, the man who was a thief was caught."
Louder.
The Bible reads,
"Behold,
that is I myself. Handle me and see, for a spirit does not have flesh and bones as you see I have."
Jesus Christ speaks to disciples. It is me. Look at my hands. Look at my feet. Spirits. Don't have flesh like the one that I'm having. That's what Jesus Christ
says.
So Jesus is telling us that spirits don't have flesh and blood. He was coming to the disciples walking on water in the morning. So the disciples were terrified, thinking they were seeing a ghost. Then he said, hey, take it easy. It is me. Look at my body, my feet. You can come and touch me. Spirits you can't touch. Spirits you can't see. Spirits don't have bodies and hands like the way you are seeing. So the first point we have established is this one. That demons are invisible wicked beings in the unseen world that are constant war against the kingdom of light. The ones that you are actually dealing with day and night. Number two, demons are fallen angels that once obeyed God and were upright in their deeds at one particular time. Remember, according to Colossians chapter 1 and verses 16, we are told that nothing in the entire universe that came into existence that came without God. All of them, whether invisible, or the things that you can see, and the powers or authority, they all came into place by God.
God created everything. Everything God created originally from the beginning, they were perfect and good. Anything that may find wicked now, if they are beings, they just decide to go against God. So demons, number two, I'm saying they are fallen angels that once obeyed God. That once obeyed God. Are you getting that? They were obeying God actually. And they were upright in their deeds before they joined hand with Lucifer. Revelation chapter 12. If you read from verses 4, the Bible clearly indicates that when Satan was thrown from heaven,
before Satan he did not come alone. The Bible says, with his tail, with his tail, he swept a third of the stars in heaven. Meaning the angels. There are some angels that joined hands with him and declared war against God in heaven. And the Bible tells us to say, Michael and his angels, they fought. And the dragon, and also his angels, they fought back. But the Bible says, that ancient snake, and he was enthralled in doubt. Fell with a number. When you talk of millions of angels that followed him, God did not kill him. He just gave him red cards from heaven. You are not worthy to be in heaven here. And so when he came here on earth, then he formed his kingdom also. He became the chief of the demons in charge of wickedness. And then what I'm going to say, that's how the kingdom of Satan comes into existence. The director in that kingdom, or the CEO in that kingdom, it is Satan himself. And with him, he has multitudes of those angels that fell. If I take you to Genesis, in chapter 6, here the Bible says, when human beings began to increase on earth, when people began to multiply on earth, the Bible says, beautiful young women began to be born on earth. Very beautiful of them, they were there that particular day. And some angels are here in heaven. The Bible says they looked at some of those women. And they saw these beautiful women that were there. They came down from heaven, took some and married them. In the intermarriage of the angels and the human beings, we have the origin of the giants on earth. People such as the Nephilims, the Goliath, and the Ogi, the one that I've been mentioning for you, the tall one. They were born in the marriages between angels and human beings. And all those angels also are fallen. They also join the kingdom of God. forget concerning demons. They were once very perfect and good beings in heaven. That's why we say they are fallen angels that at one time also obeyed God. And were upright in their deeds before they decided to turn away from the ways of God. Now I hope you read Revelation chapter 12. Verses 4 to 9 on that point. Number 3, which is C. Because demons are disembodied, they look for a body. They look for bodies. To inhabit in order for them to carry out their mission. Let me repeat this one. Before we go to the other way. Because demons don't have bodies. So, seriously, they look for bodies. Whether human bodies, or animal bodies, any creature, but the best body. But the body, which is their first priority, it is the body of a human being. Church, if you're following that, very big. A human being body is the best choice demons look for. If they can find one, they'll come in and pick the and call that place their house. Church out together. So they look for body to inhabit. In order for them to carry out their mission, as assigned by their master Satan. Then once they enter that body, they will call that body, "This is our house." They call them, "This is our place." And then they will begin to exercise some authority over that body. In the book of Luke chapter 11 and verses 24, you can write it, Luke chapter 11 and verses 24. The Bible says, when an evil spirit comes out of a person, when an evil spirit comes out of a person, the Bible says, it says to itself, can you follow what I'm going to say here? Are you following me? Look at another tells them. Demons look for a body. They can't do their work on earth if they cannot find a body they can inhabit. Church out together. So in the book of Luke 11:24, when the spirit comes out of the person, it goes in empty places, looking for a place to rest. Meaning they don't just actually hang in the atmosphere. When they are chased out of this body, they will go looking for another place. And the Bible says, that spirit does not find a place to enter and rest. Then it says to itself, I will go back to my former house. You hear? You see? You can hear that one? They'll say, Baba, to my house. They are calling the boat they came out from. That is our house. And the Bible opposites. When that spirit goes, first of all, the spirit
check.
Before entering the house where they were in, if they find that the things are just the same,
the
way they left that place, it is empty. There is no Jesus. And the house is totally in shambles. It is the way the demon left it. The Bible says again, that spirit you say, let me go back
before the
and collect other enforcement. The
Bible
says, that spirit you go back and invite other seven spirits that are more powerful than itself. If there was one demon, and then that spirit goes and invites seven spirits, situation of this person will be worse than the first one. And driving those type of demons, driving them out, such type of demons, now it becomes difficult. Because they
are
now in numbers. And they have joined power and forces. Perhaps these are the ones Jesus Christ said.
Me have now just blessed and this one.
Unless you pray fasting, this kind you can't deal with
it. Why not? We ponder what we can manage.
So we see that actually,
me now want to pull it.
Demons,
man, demons,
refer the inhabiting place.
You want to have to put them
as their house.
Just like
you have control over your house, demons begin to have control over the body in which they inhabit. The nature and the characters of that person they are living in becomes that of demons also. Because they have to make sure that they control that person, what they do, what they say, everything, they begin to control them. So number three, we have established one point here.
But
for demons to carry out their mission here on earth, they look for a body in which they can inhabit. And if they find one, they will enter that body, call that body the house, and begin to do their mission. If you're following and being blessed by that teaching, number four, that is number D. We are looking at demons here. Demons can embody human beings.
I don't
get a change. Animals, any other creatures. Do we have proof in the Bible that demons can enter animals, can enter other creatures, Mark chapter 5. Mark chapter 5. Verses 8 to verses 13.
Quickly, somebody
read that one.
Mark 5, 8 to 13.
Yes.
He said this because Jesus was saying, evil spirits, come out of this man.
Evil spirits, come out of this man.
So Jesus asked him,
Jesus asked,
what is your name?
What is your name?
The man answered,
the man answered,
my name is Mob.
My name is Mob.
There are so many of us.
Meaning we are so many in this land.
And they kept begging Jesus not to send the evil spirits.
And the demons kept begging Jesus, please don't send the evil spirits
out of that region.
Uh-huh.
There was a large herd of pigs.
Now listen, that there was a large herd of pigs.
Feeding on a hillside.
They were feeding on the hillside.
So the spirits begged Jesus.
So the spirits begged Jesus.
Send us to the pigs.
Send us where, church? The demons were begging Jesus and send us where?
And
let us go into them. He let them go, and the evil spirits went out of the man and entered the pigs.
Listen to me. Jesus allowed the evil spirits to enter the pigs.
Me Jesus Christ alumeneza matimona ukena mamlaka wa
shukube. The evil spirit came out of that man.
Mimiya emas yazwa kumuna ya.
For information, that man was a madman.
Kalwamina, inapuna yari, inimuna yanapumuka.
And it were demons that brought that madness upon him.
Minye lima demona, anata isizeku yangana koke na muna yari.
And so when they went out of the man,
mi anazwile kumuna yo,
they entered into what?
Mi kato haona akena kai.
Agent?
Anu utukereke?
They entered the pit.
Mi akena mamulaka walikurube.
This picture,
mi wana sibusipose,
clearly shows us
that
demons
can
embody animals
or other creatures.
Read it downward. Let me hear what happened to that man
quickly.
Read downward
quickly.
The whole herd, about 2,000 pigs in all, rushed down the side of the
now pit. Imagine one human being had 2,000 demons. Because the
2,000,
the evil spirits will manage to enter them. Go ahead.
Verse 14.
Rush down the side of the cliff into the lake and was drowned.
And the pigs, by the control of evil spirits, they rushed and entered the river, all of
them.
If it was a human being, you'd say he has committed suicide. Because when the demons entered there, they all rushed into the waters.
Ran away and spread the news in the towns and among the farms.
Uh-huh.
People went out to see what had happened.
Uh-huh.
And when they came to Jesus,
uh-huh,
they saw the man who used to have the mob of demons in
uh-huh
him.
Uh-huh.
He was sitting there,
uh-huh,
clothed and in his right mind.
In his right mind.
And
the fact that what the thing that was causing madness had gone out of that man, he came back.
And
if you read the story, the road that he used to walk, people had stopped using it. Because the man was violent.
And
very strong. Because they took the character of the spirits that were living in his body. No, they were giving him, they were controlling him what to do. The Bible even says they would chain his hands and feet. And you would break them. Smash them. Because anyone there was 2,000. In one man, there were 2,000. So it was like 1 in 2,000
in 2,000.
So if you're managing, you have to come
and move again.
So we are trying to establish the fact that
we
can stand in both, both human beings and other creatures as well. They can enter. Where they are permitted. So now, as I'm concluding on this part here, I don't want you to go with fear here. Do demons enter the body as they wish at any time, at any hour? It's a question. Do demons? Can they enter anybody? At any time, I'm trying to look at that question. When the demons entered the pit, who gave them permission? Demons understand. But they cannot enter anybody
anyhow
unless they are given permission. And there are two permissions. Either the permission of Jesus, or the permission of us ourselves. Demons can enter a body, either of a human being, another creature, by two permissions. One, either the permission of God, or the permission of man himself. So you don't have to be afraid, thinking that, oh, I'm in a big battle. So demons can enter me anytime they feel like. That's why they begged Jesus, don't send us out of this place, but send us into the pigs, please. Jesus allowed them so that he may give us a teaching that demons don't enter at will anybody wants. Accept the
appellate.
That's what the Bible says. Do not give Satan, do not give the devil a chance. Do not open a door for him. Neither give him any place. It means it is our disposal. It is in our hands to block him or to tell him, come again. So today, I'm ending here. We were looking at the definition for who demons really are. Partly, how they enter bodies. So number one, I said, they are disembodied spirits. Beings that are constant that war against the kingdom of light. These demons are spirits, and they don't have flesh and bones. We can't touch them, Number two, I say, demons are fallen angels, but once obeyed God, and they were upright in their deeds before they joined hands with Lucifer. Number three, I say, because demons are disembodied, they look for bodies where they can stay and execute their mission as assigned by the master Satan. Number four, I say, demons can embod human beings or another creature, but under permission. Under the permission of God,
our permission. They don't enter at their will,
we are not to help.
As they feel,